In today's video, I'm going to talk about an upcoming real-time strategy game called Call to Arms, Gates of Hell, Ostfront. What it's about? First of all, a real-time strategy game aimed at portraying historical events from World War II in both single-player and multiplayer campaigns. Release date? The time expected, according to the developers, around September 2020, in this year. The developers of this game: Barbed Wire Studios and Digitalmindsoft. Publisher: Digitalmindsoft. Digitalmindsoft, the company behind Men of War, both games, and this tells a lot for me. And wondering already if Gates of Hell, Ostfront, is going to have similar graphics to Men of War and Company of Heroes already. Or similar, or very close, you understand. Now, according to the name, as it suggests, Ostfront, it's about the Eastern Front early in the game. But the developers have mentioned that the game will feature the Eastern Front on the initial release date, but gradually, with new DLCs and expansion, they will try to cover even other fronts of World War II as the game will develop. Wonder if they will cover Italy, if they will cover African campaign or Western Front, since Normandy or France. Will be interesting. Now, features. The developers promise a vast amount of units and equipment, from which you can choose, from tanks to vehicles to soldiers. You can select one of them only, or you can command entire units. Now, to some extent, you can move with the keys they already mentioned: W, A, S, and D. You can aim, shoot with the mouse, exactly like in Men of War, if you remember. You can also throw grenades, change ammunition, loot crates, laying mines. These are the possibilities they are presenting right now. As I mentioned earlier, and as the developers promise, the game will feature initially only a German and a Soviet single-player campaigns. And then it will expand once the game will be released, after the game will be released. And the campaigns can be played in online or in single player. Unlike other real-time strategy games, the developers promised historical accuracy. Graphics, all landscape, elements, vehicles, uniforms, weapons, and content is rigorously designed with precision to ensure that the goal of the game is to meet and honor those who fought in the great conflict. The only thing that will suffer some modification are political symbols. This is what they mention. Also, the combat and the mechanics will differ from mission to mission. If you remember Men of War, the developer already mentions you may face superior foes, you can outmaneuver them or try to immobilize them, and also, depending on the type of vehicle and ammunition, the vehicle can either have jump turrets, or you can stun the crew of enemy vehicles, you can blow up their entire ammunition or even their fuel supplies. It depends already and it differs from mission to mission. Now, also the terrain will be taken into account, so you can choose different vehicles and troops accordingly to the map presented in the mission. Different maps will encourage different choices of vehicles. So don't use tiger tanks when it's a swamp. And regarding the vehicles, even the ballistics will differ from vehicle to vehicle. The impact, the promise, and the ammo types are going to differ from vehicle to vehicle. And even the ammunition layout. And the impact of the shot on the enemy targets will differ accordingly to the ballistics. Distance, terrain, armor type. And actually, they promise that the sky will also be used in very actively in campaigns. Wish to know better if the aviation will play a decisive role in this campaign, in this game, or they will have rather a support role. Now, regarding the requirements for this game. So we have two operating system, Windows 7, 8 or 10. The CPU, Intel Pentium 2.5 GHz or newer. Memory, 2 GB of RAM. For GPU, NVIDIA GT 720 or AMD R7 240 or newer. Now, for space, you need 8 GB of space on your hardware. And recommended, again, Windows 7, 8 or 10. The CPU, Intel Core E5, 2.5 GHz or E7 already at recommended. So, it's very pretentious here. Memory, 8 GB of RAM, 8 GB. Now, for GPU, NVIDIA GTX 750 or AMD R7 260X. Also, for hard space, 12 GB total space required. Any additional info? Let's check. We will also implement a dynamic campaign, which will allow you to grow your army from mission to mission. This sounds very interesting. From mission to mission. Will it be like Blitzkrieg, if you know? Blitzkrieg, where from mission to mission you can keep the same units you have upgraded and increase the size of your starting army at the beginning of each mission. I'm very curious. And like, you know, you have won a mission from a campaign, you received, let's say, a Tiger tank, and you can use it at the beginning of each other mission until you can upgrade it to another vehicle later in the game. You know the principle from Blitzkrieg. Wonder, because they say they will extend the game after release to other campaigns. Wonder if Italy will be a playable nation in this campaign, this game. Well, this game sounds promising from my point of view, so definitely worth trying once it will be released. Hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful.